Hey yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replay! Again on Terraform Ladder Edition, this time against some Master League Protoss. So here we are, spawning as the blue Protoss in the right bottom position. It's Roost. And his opponent, as always me, the red Terran, spawning in the left top position of Terraform, it's Alex Usher. So, I have no clue why this game is good or not, but we will see soon, I guess. So the only thing, okay, pylon quite nicely here, as well as the supply depot. Yeah, that's the only thing I liked about Legacy of the Void. Is as a caster or observer, the games don't take that long to start. But as a player, I really like the first few minutes in StarCraft 2 Heart of the Swarm. As a player, I like it. I like to play, to stack the worker. It's, I like it. I can't explain why, but I like it. Yeah. So here we go with the gateway and the probe, as well as the simulator. Standard stuff for Roost. I like this name. Roost is a good name for a player, I would say. Better than Demon Hunter XXX or Ghost Nuker 1967. I have no clue. There are some weird names out there. Or Barcode. Blah. But yeah. So here we go with the SCV. Mop, mop, mop. Scouting around as well as the probe. Mop, mop, mop. Reaper should be out soon. There we go. Probe sees it and goes away. Behind that we have the cybernetics core. Oh, really nice stacking on that probe. I like that. That was a good mineral stacking there. Really well done. And yeah, the SCV goes in, sees the cybernetics core. Woo! Floating around. And sees the gateway as well. Oh, Roos pulling two probes here to be annoying. And deal with the SCV, which could be very annoying to block. Oh my god, oh no, okay. I thought I would have done this, but apparently I didn't. That would have been so nice to block the Nexus with the SCV after the one probe went away. But yeah, here we have the sneaky probe being really annoying. Reaper doesn't find it, goes straight across the map. We will see a factory soon. Probe still there. I guess the purpose for this probe is not to put down a pylon, but... Or maybe it does, okay. There we go. If you can do it, sure, why not? If it's out of the map. I thought the main purpose would be to scout if it's Widowmine drop or not. Or factory or tomb or barracks. But yeah. Maybe not this time. I guess I start to remember this game. Oh god. Yeah, very interesting one. Mothership Core is out, Stalker will be out as well soon, the Reaper just on patrol command. I didn't see the second gas here, but here we go with the Twilight Council. Oh my goodness. There's the Reaper, there is the Stalker, will see the Reaper and attack it. And ooh, good reaction here, that was close. If the Stalker would have went way near the Reaper and then started to attack and kite, I guess the Reaper would have died. But so it's okay. Twilight Council so far. So we could see two base blink pressure. Ooh, Dark Templar! Dark Templar Shrine, Dark Shrine, DT Shrine, okay. DTs is the choice for Roost. And this can do you a lot of damage because Dark Templar, they are fast. They are cloaked, they have super sharp Psy Blades, Shadow Psy Blades, I guess. And there's nothing here to detect them, but two orbital commands without any energy. Yeah, Dark Templar Shrine, the only good thing is it takes so long. It's a two-based Dark Templar, and it's not with drop. There is a robotics, but it's way out of position for the Dark Templar, I guess. Would be strange to have Dark Templar warped in with the warp prism, as this robotics is so late, the warp prism would be late, even with chrono boost, and then it has to go across the map all the way. But here we have double pylons, and marines are on the way. Oh, that's not looking good. Marines on the way, widow mines on the way, but Dark Templar will be warped in as well. There we have the forge, that's good. Do we have the observer? There we go, observer being chrono boosted out here, and now we will see how much damage each player can deal to the other. One DT goal gets warped in. Not a second one. Oh, he got no gas for it yet. Okay. There we are with the Widowmine drop. And with the Reaper. So Photon Overcharge is being casted. There's the Reaper. I get the Sentry. Widowmine being burrowed. Focus down the Stalker. Here we have the Dark Templar. Raven takes some time. 10 kills off with the Widowmines and the Marines. The Mothership Core will escape. As it looks like, 13 kills back at home. This Dark Templar, really, really good. That's so annoying. So, 15 SCVs killed, 16. Oh, there's another Dark Templar at the Natural. The Widowmine kills this one, but there are a lot more SCVs here to kill, 4 more SCVs, and I can't lose any SCV. 22 to 36 is not good, but there are the Widowmines. They got some more shots, 2 in total, which is okay. So, ooh, there's no detection here, there's the Observer. The Dark Templar dealt a lot of damage here, killing 2 more SCVs. Supply-wise, it's quite equal, but this leads to me being in a deficit of workers. But I had an army. And there's Widowmine. Gets 2 more kills. So unfortunately for me, not being able to get the sentry. But overall, it's quite equal, I would say, at that stage of the game. With mules, you can see. It's okay. So Dark Templar, definitely a good counter to my Widowmine drop stuff. If I would do the ring around, the rosy ring around, the merry-go-around with the SCVs, I could have maybe reduced the damage taken, but it's okay for now. Lose the head and supply, but very nicely getting the upgrade, the armor upgrade. And for me, we got the engineering bay. I need it for turrets. I don't know if it's a war prism or not, could be the case later on. We got the Dark Templar shrine. So far, I'm not mining gas, but just going for the minerals. I need that urgent. And there we have more factories. Army supply? Favoring no roost. But he's going for heavy tech. Colossus. He did. So he doesn't know that it's mech. He saw the Raven, which is. So if you. Normally, if you see bio, you don't see Raven ever. If you see a Raven, it's most likely mech in any time. At least against Protoss. Because the Raven, it takes 200. Minerals and 100 minerals and 200 gas, and those 200 gas you want to pump into stim and combat shields and maybe plus one, and not into a Raven if you're playing bio, because you need to keep up with the upgrades of the Protoss. This Colossus, a bit of a misclick, I guess. Hallucinating a Colossus moving across the map. I guess we'll never reach my main base, but it's fine. There we have a Widowmine sneaking across the map, burrowing right here and killing the rocks there. There's the Phoenix. Will get killed by that Widowmine? No. Oh, and there's the Colossi. So, if you didn't know it, the hallucinations, they take double damage from any source. So, a Marine dealing 6 damage to a hallucination, he would deal 12 damage. And that's really interesting to know. So, even if you don't scan, if you are able to pay very close attention to this in a fight, you might see which one is a hallucination and which one not. But that's very, very difficult. Also, you could, as a Protoss, for example, use hallucination Immortal. Ooh, Widowmine. Because the Immortal Hardened Shields also applies for the hallucination. But they took double damage, so not 10 per hit, but 20. But still, that could be 5 tank shots worth of no damage dealt, especially because it's too hallucination. So hallucinations can be very useful in as a Protoss player, having some Or Archons, they have a lot of shields, for example. It can help. Or send in hallucinated zealots for Widowmines, such like that. Stuff like that. So we have some Hellions here, ready to pounce, but this army is in position. The upgrades are looking quite good for Roost here. I got no upgrades so far. No upgrades, that's really bad. I need plus one. I need the Drilling Claws and Blue Flame as well. And there are a lot of probes here. And there we go, moving into this. Killing. One. Two, three. Not too many kills. This force field a bit annoying for those probes. Oh, look at that. Nice. I didn't notice, but nice. Okay, not the biggest blunder there, but can make a difference. And here we have the pylon and the Dark Temple Shrine and extended thermal lens plus one attack being researched. I like the map vision Roost got in this game. It's really good. Look at that. Just at the bottom we could use another pylon or observer or anything. So with this Phoenix he sees me taking a base. He got some zealots there. Being very annoying. Denying the gas. Very nicely. Killing a Hellion? Yes. Okay. And sees me taking a base. As you can see, income wise, I'm not really good here. As my harvest account is quite low. But I got a lot of mules, so I guess it's fine for now. Yeah, there we go. Mule hammer. And I still got a lot of energy on those orbital commands. There we go. So let's have a look at the income. We'll raise highly. Ooh! I guess there was a Dark Templar killing a tank. So I need turrets here to be able to defend. I could need a turret at the front as well. Maybe here at the production. Yeah, look at the income. But, didn't get it. Look at a war prison, for example, sneaking in here. Getting one Dark Templar for each add-on. That would be such a cool harass technique. But Roost not going for this. Roost instead deciding to attack. I see it with the Marine, so I will be able to scan. Swing! There we go. I see his army, see his upgrades, know what's going on. There are no High Templar with this army. So, he needs to be careful. He got a Mothership Core, which is indeed helpful. Oh, he's taking another base. This Hellion gets taken out. But yeah, I guess. Oh, look at the income I got, the bank. Ooh, sneaking at that one. Good thing I have my Widowmine there. But I need to produce more production facilities. Get the Banshees up and such. Maybe Ghosts even. Ghosts would be so nice. You need Ghosts. Ghosts is good against Protoss. And Widowmine gets a shot off, kills a salad. Nice. And now I know, there he is. Scan goes down. He could walk up with the Colossi. There he goes. Carefully there. Very carefully there. He loses the Mothership Core. That's not good. So no recall. And I guess he will just turn back. There are two Marines coming here. I may have pressed F2 to select all units on the map, which is not good. All army units, not the harvesters. Income wise, I'm okay. 66 would be very good as a max player, I guess. Or 72 first for the gas, and later on you can dump SCVs as you got more orbital commands. But yeah, finally getting the starports very late. But this is a very passive game as well, and I got a lot of Vikings. Let's have a look at the army. 11 tanks against 5 Immortals, 16 Widowmines, ooh, dealing a lot of damage potentially. High Templar with Storm. Okay, how much energy do they have? Come on. Let me please click the High Templar. There we go. A lot of energy. One Storm each, which is fine. And it looks like he wants to assault my third base. Well, I'm going... Oh, that's not good for me. This could potentially kill me. I mean, I got some Widowmines here. And two tanks. And such halberds and a sensor turret. But I'm way out of position. I'm so way out of position. Oh, I scan it. That Jedi sends this man. And he waits. He scouts and sees. He baits the Widowmine. Not even does that. Oh! 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 The Widowmines! In the end, good split, but the first ones were really good. And here he goes. Storms loses the mothership core to the turret. Very unfortunate here. And goes in. Oh, very good storm on top of the Widowmines and the Vikings. But there's not enough anti-air to deal with the Vikings here. Colossus goes down. The Immortals staying strong. Some tanks sieged, some not sieged. There are Widowmines. And overall, the Archon's dying here as well. But he dealt some damage here. Put me down to 49 SCVs. Killed a lot. But as you can see, I've traded a bit better. But still, economic damage was dealt. And he still got the pylon down there, so he can work with that. I got fortunately plus 2, and finally I can get the Banshees, but there is no cloak yet. Just plus 3 starting. Should put this one into auto command. Finally a turret ring as well, just in case of a war prism. I don't know why most Protoss players are not using war prism against mech early in the game, because it's super strong, it's super annoying, and you can take a third base, go double forge behind that. If you really put an impression on your opponent, you can do this. And here we are. Yeah, here we have the Stalker. Gets killed. Two Widowmines. Bam, bam, bam. He gets a tank, which is okay, I guess, but overall, he's not trading too good here. Losing a lot of stuff here as well. The Raven saved the day. As those turrets are really nice with the damage output, even though those Zealots are a hell of a tank, but yeah, the supplies still look at all those gateways. Holy Roost, are you serious? Yes, he is. There he goes, but still, there is the Raven. He's being a bit annoying with the Zealots, killing this turret and some SCVs. But yeah, this looking good, repairing stuff here. I would love to see some more supply depots to block off Zealots, and maybe one, two Hellbats and a Banshee here just for defensive purposes. As you can see, nice split here and multi-prong Harris again. But technically, I mean, he got the minerals but not the gas, but technically he's just throwing away a bunch of minerals for almost nothing. Yeah, and if he keeps doing this, it's not dealing any damage. He's not dealing economic damage. He gets a tank and a widow mine and maybe a supply depot. But he's wasting a lot of gas with the Dark Templar and also some minerals for those Zealots. And yeah, if he keeps going doing this, this can be difficult. And I never realized that those minerals at the high ground are boxed in, while those are on the low ground are normal. That's so cool. I like that. Overall, I would say it's looking quite okay. Oh, there's somewhere a High Templar, a Dark Templar. There's the Raven finally coming. So Raven very important, still no Ghost Academy. Another attempt to attack here. Ah, from three angles, but he just gets one tank there, another one here, and a third one. So that was not too bad. Get some tanks, be a bit annoying, but I got the bank. Look at the bank, he's way too inactive. Sticking on Zealots and Dark Templar is not gonna win him the game, I guess. I could lose another tank here. Oh, very unfortunate, but yeah. He's taking the gold base. He's trying to keep up. He got a lot of Archons, but Colossi are not good against this composition. Vikings are good, Banshees are good. He got... That's the only good thing he got, like 10 High Templar, the Archons, and some Immortal, but he's so clumped. Still, I could need Ghosts. Ghosts would be really nice to have. There we are, some Zealots again, as well as at the third base, but he's just throwing away units for nothing. He gets a tank again, okay, but this time there's a Banshee here to defend. And ooh, sieging up that base. That could be good. A big warping coming in, will be killed immediately. The Hellbats go down. Oh, nice storms, but he's walking into the storms with his Archons. The splash of the Widowmines. Ooh, but he got a lot of High Templar left. He will be able to kill the Banshees. Widowmines are okay. Good storms here. Loses all the Colossi there. Another Widowmine shot, but in the end, able to clear this. Oh, the Viking land, so annoying. Killing stuff here. And... Oh no, there are two Widowmines. There are two Widowmines. Ah! Nein! Oh, loses the Archon there. More Widowmines. Ooh, there's the Banshee, and no. He can't feedback, but it doesn't matter. He got no Stalker or Phoenix to defend this Banshee. So he will lose most likely the High Templar. Good blink here. And this base. Oh, still some Widowmines here. But yeah, overall you can see his bank depleted. I got a high gas count as well. Even though I'm not mining gas properly, but it's okay. I can maintain it. I really should throw down more production facilities like ghosts, more factories, 2 more starports, 2 more factories, and maybe 3 barracks with the ghost academy. Maybe even 2 to 3 ghost academies for nukes. But for now, a big weapon. The problem is he's wasting so much minerals, so many minerals on a base I don't need now, because I got the gas income. I can mine gas from the 5th base here and the 4th base as well. So he's trading away salads. He's dealing a good amount of damage here, being very annoying, but this base, I don't need it anymore. So he totally misreads the importance of this base. Banshee killing a pile and being annoying. Overall, he did really well with the worker killed. He's getting the shield upgrade, but yeah. There we go, 2 more factories. Finally, he's killing the sensor turret. Might get this. Oh, so close. Come on. No, it's getting killed. Two Banshees still there. And as you can see, he's struggling with the gas. He can't maintain his high-tech army. I don't know why he's going for Colossus. I mean, there are Vikings and Banshees on Mars. He can't win with Colossus. Maybe it's against the Widowmines, but very difficult to play here for him. And he's throwing away a lot of more stock salads, as you can see. Yes, he's clearing tanks. Yes, he's trading here, but in the end, he has thrown away like 12 to 14 zealots, like 1,400 minerals for a couple of tanks and a sensor turret. He just isn't able to trade efficient enough, as you can see. All those resources could be gas and minerals, so this means I got a bank, he doesn't. And if you got a bank as a mech player, go throw down some more orbital commands, not like 10, but 2 or 3. Get 2 more factories, 2 more starports, and go for ghosts if you're playing against Protoss. Or even against Terran, because it may help to EMP the Raven. So here we have the Archons, some Hellbats, and a big weapon of Zealots. Ooh, this might be just enough to deal with that. A big fight coming here. Storms, okay, good spread. But in the end, I guess I'm spread it too much, as he can deal with this army quite nicely. And in the end, even though he's down in supply a bit, he could commit to this. But there's a planetary with a tank. He could commit to this, but he got no bank left. The income is okay, but not really good. I guess he doesn't feel like doing this. This orbital command could die. And there we have one immortal Widowmine. That was very, very expensive. Would have been better to send something else like a hallucination. This High Templar, Dark Templar, really being annoying with this turret. There we go. Oh, Widowmine. Oh, tank shot. Not too good here. And I still got the bank. Okay, my mining isn't the best one, but it's looking bad for him. Upgrade-wise, I'm okay. I mean, all I need to have is the damage. Mech units die against Protoss quite fast, so I don't really need the armor. Having it is good, of course, I should have had it, but it is okay, I would say. And yeah, really difficult spot for him to be in. No mining going up here, this base difficult. He might lose. Oh, the Dark Templar, the splash! Not enough. Oh, it is enough to kill. Nice splash hype. Some SUVs getting killed here, thrown away, which is okay. And I'm up 70 supply. I still got a bank, not the biggest bank. I would have loved to be on 2000. I guess I will lose orbital command, but okay. He still goes down there with all of his army, which is a big mistake, I guess. Yeah, he gets the Widowmines, but he's completely open to a big attack right now, and I don't need to deal with this army. I got enough back at home with the reinforcements, but I'm pulling back everything. I don't like that. I should keep two tanks here, maybe a Banshee, just in case. But okay. Yeah, losing those salads. He can't trade like that. You saw he got the 3.5k bank. He had it. And now it's depleted completely. There are some probes. Not gonna explode. But oh, the Banshees! He got 3 observer, all with the map. But needs to be very carefully not to lose them to the Vikings. Income wise, yeah, the game slowed down a little bit, but I got the bank. I'm setting up. Oh, I need to be so carefully. Still no ghosts. Imagine 2 ghosts. Pew, pew. Have 2 MPs right there. All his army would have had no shields and energy. And this is it. Trying to snipe the observer. Getting one. Just one so far. But it's okay. We just got 2 left. Really nice stuff is the Stalker here being annoying. And I can't even attack those. Very annoying. He tries to stall as much time as he can. And somehow my oh, I'm going for Raven. I switched into Raven. This could be very difficult. This could get very difficult for the Protoss guy. There we go. Very good feedbacks. Very, very good feedbacks. But losing a lot there. I'm going in full NA. The Zealots from behind. Very good against the baiting the Widowmines there. But goal achieved. He lost a lot. He lost all his observers. Oh, you can't go in like that. No. He lost so much to the Widowmines at the tank fire. He can't deal with the Banshees. And that's why Banshee is key to win against Protoss. Because of stuff like that. He has no cannon, no observer. Those Banshees, look at the damage, and they are on plus 3 damage. And behind that I got some Raven as well. I'm producing a whole lot. My bank depleted completely, but it is okay, I guess, with the mules I got. As I am on 5 orbital commands, could have been more. But it's okay. It really is. And I guess he just can't deal with this attack. So, denying another base, he's still got the gold base. Which is good, but will it be enough there? I'm completely maxed again. Taking another base here. The income? Really good for me. Ooh. I really don't know if there's any way for him to win this game now. I should get the refineries up. But oh! Carefully there, losing a lot. Not the best engagement here, but now I'm cutting this base. I will be able to assault the gold. And there he goes in. PTD is very useful. Needs to turn back. Vikings are really good against those Colossi. Killing the Banshee. Blinking there. Oh! You don't see the Widowmines! Oh my god! Oh, and there we go. GG. A very long and intense game, but I was proud of myself, I guess. I didn't go for ghosts. I should have taken more bases. But in the end, it was a solid play. Whew. One more game to cast. So, see you next time, hopefully. I also hope that you enjoyed this one. If you have any critics or feedback, please let me know. And with that, as always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye.